The dialogue is what is taking
many
time.
Committees.
The dialogue with Mr. L.K. Advani.
No, leave it. At least leave it to us. At least let the time.
Several rounds of meetings.
I'm sorry. I don't think. I don't think.
L.K. Advani today on a one-on-one. Bhaiya Ji Joshi met him. So the dialogue is what is taking time.
Navika, I don't think Navika Kumar is a member of parliamentary board to force a decision about that. The decision will be taking appropriate time, surely. And the people of the country are waiting to throw Congress lock, stock and barrel whenever elections are held for the suffering they have caused to the people of the country.
Yes, Dr. Singh, we wanted to come.
This musical concert I've been hearing all this while has actually meant that 4 months, a full 4 months, a raucous, non-musical, dissonant, karkash dhwani is being heard, where you are having a cabal of squabblers, jostlers and jockeyers for power, fighting amongst themselves, not able to decide a prime ministerial candidate for 4 months.
Abhishek, you, at least there is no one liner at the height of 40,000 feet
as
by the prime minister.
Rag Darbari. If he describes this as lack of Dark Darbari, thank God, we have a more methodical system of proceeding. Yes. The country is watching.
At least there is no one liner at
like
the height of 40,000 feet.
Jockeying for power. And
I
Mr. Advani thinks that the most unfair have been not anybody else, but the BJP has been most unfair.
Finally, in the Pappu versus Peku war, it seems that Rahul Gandhi seems to have decided. He's speaking on the same day as Narendra Modi. Narendra Modi speaks tomorrow in Jaipur, where he's concluding the yatra with Vasundhara Raje, the BJP's chief ministerial hopeful. And Rahul Gandhi is making a public speech in Delhi. Do you think finally Rahul Gandhi has thrown his hat in the fray and has decided to take speech versus speech? Narendra Modi
Navika,
versus Rahul Gandhi. And is that a formula that suits the Congress?
Navika, I hope you don't take your political leads from such superficial coincidences. The Congress has not yet begun the art of fixing our schedules on the basis of prior searching of the BJP schedules. Don't refer to pure coincidences. For the Congress, it doesn't matter where, what, when Mr. Modi is speaking. For the Congress, it has never been a presidential one versus two contest. I've explained that to you earlier.
But Abhishek, you are not scared of Narendra Modi.
He has been speaking. He speaks what he thinks, and the whole country knows that while Mr. Modi uses big words, big adjectives, rhetoric, flourish, nobody thinks him half as sincere, as straightforward, as pointed and focused as Mr. Rahul Gandhi. Everybody knows that he doesn't always, frequently does not mean what he says and says what he means. Mr. Rahul Gandhi, Shelley is totally different. You have seen his actions. People have seen his actions over the last 3 years at the grassroots. He has spoken when he wants to on issues which he wants to. He
but Dr. Singhvi, you yourself are making this comparison now.
And to think that that is
See,
not
Dr.
a statement.
Singhvi,
I'm not. I'm answering you. I'm answering your previous question.
Dr. Singhvi, you yourself are making this comparison now.
That Mr. Rahul Gandhi has not done this.
Which are not
I'm answering that question.
And on the other hand, Rahul Gandhi takes a position. Yes, please go ahead.
On the contrary, if I don't answer your question goes unrebutted. I am specifically answering your question and Mr. Ravishankar Prasad's point about Mr. Rahul Gandhi not having spoken or his views on various topics. And that question, I think, is left to be answered by the people of this country. They know the sincerity quotient of Mr. Modi. Everybody knows that he speaks in a political style which is usually 90%
insincere. This is a new quotient.
Everybody
this is
knows
a new quotient
that
in
the
Indian
claim,
politics.
The claim
sincerity
he makes in
quotient.
Gujarat.
The,
of course it is. Anybody, even the worst enemies of Rahul Gandhi concede, even in the BJP, privately and otherwise.
Dr. Singhvi, on 1 to 10, where does Rahul Gandhi stand? On the
Rahul Gandhi is so sincere, Dr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi, then why doesn't he talk on a host of issues? There are several questions. What are the kind of economic policy that Rahul Gandhi would
he
actually
has,
follow?
He
what
has
does he think
talked
of the
on
UP,
a host
UP
of
communal
issues.
Situation currently? What does he think about what's going on in
one
Kashmir?
What does he think about
India-Pakistan relations? Why doesn't he speak on all of these issues?
No. This is a false debate. This is a false debate. Mr. Rahul Gandhi has spoken on several of these issues. But in particular, He is the vice president of the party and the party functions under his leadership. When the Congress speaks, it is in consultation with the vice president and the president. What we say from the podium all over the place is after prior discussion and consultation.
These are the issues that Indians want to talk about. Indians want to know about.
I'll tell you, on the very same issues, the Congress party has spoken, which means Rahul Gandhi and Sonia Gandhi have spoken. Separately, Rahul Gandhi has spoken sometimes, but Rahul Gandhi doesn't have to speak every day as the Congress party speaks. And that's the false debate.
Navika, can I come in here?
This is a debate which is trying to be drawn into a presidential debate.
Dr. Ravi Shankar Prasad is not convinced. Go on, Dr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, your rebut.
That's the whole point.
Well, Navika, I have to say something very simply. I'm happy you pointed out Abhishek has not spoken as to what is the view of Rahul Gandhi on a whole range of issues. He's surely entitled to shower all the adjectives of appreciation and commendation of Rahul Gandhi. I have no problem with that. But I have yet to hear any structured intervention of Rahul Gandhi in the parliament in the last more than 4 years that he has been there, or many years. The only speech I remember is that Kalavati or Leelavati halting speech. What happened to Kalavati? Where is she? We don't even know. If that is the earnestness of his speaking style, today I have been led to a new understanding of India's politics, that what Abhishek Manu Singhvi speaks is Rahul Gandhi is speaking. I'm happy to hear that.
But the
I'm
question on sincerity quotient,
if that is
Mr.
the
Prasad,
way
the Congress the sincerity quotient of Mr. Modi.
Yes.
The question
well, sincerity quotient goes in the governance record.
Of your leader.
Sanket, yes. Sanket, sincerity quotient must be reflected not only in his speech, but also in his your governance record. And this question I'm leaving to your
That's
viewers today. Why is it when the country's growth is -5%, all the BJP rural states, that Chhattisgarh or Madhya Pradesh or Gujarat or Goa are posting 11% plus growth rate? Why is it when investors are not trusting government of India, they are trusting these states? Why is it that even farmers are happy
Several
having
states.
18% and 15% growth rate?
But
these
what about
are important
your
issues.
The answer,
and therefore,
the answer is simple.
That I have already
answered.
That I have already replied to you, Madam Navika Kumar. Wait for the decision of Parliamentary Board.
Navika. Mr. Navika, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, Navika.
Wait for Parliamentary Board decision.
Haryana,
Navika, surely.
Haryana.
I know your concern will be addressed.
Please. Look, let's not have false figures.
Go on, Dr.
Haryana is posting the same growth rates. Delhi is posting the same growth rates. He has selective amnesia about these states. Rajasthan is posting close to these rates.
Then what why you are not doing in the country?
And
Abhishek, tell me that.
And I'll tell you about
Abhishek
us.
Abhishek Manu Singhvi.
I'll tell you.
Why
I'll
is
tell you about us.
Why is
let
India not
me.
Having this growth rate?
That's the question.
Why not?
Let me tell you.
Why Manmohan Singh is not? Why the
let
great
me answer, Ravi Shankar Prasad. Have the patience and courage to hear my answer. Have the patience and courage to hear my answer without interrupting me.
Yes, I know.
From 98 to 2004, you in the NDA had an average growth rate of 5.6%. Can I answer? You are interrupting me because you don't want to face facts.
Abhishek, talk
you had
today,
a growth rate of 5.6%.
Talk in 2013.
And from 2004.
Don't run away from
2004 to 2013.
Gentlemen, this is
from
not the
Rajya
Sabha.
Our average growth rate is still higher than yours.
It's like
last year, it was
charged for
a half time job.
You are running away from
2013.
You are obfuscating.
Let's not quibble over numbers. The question that we started off asking this evening was, is the BJP
you are
ready
not
to announce
answer
Narendra
heard,
Modi
Navika,
as its Prime Ministerial candidate and is
because
the Congress
no answer,
now
Abhishek.
Being forced to decide whether
Navika,
Rahul Gandhi will be its Prime Ministerial
Navika,
candidate as well?
Navika,
that
half
question,
a second.
Unfortunately,
Navika, half
neither
a second.
Of the gentlemen have answered. Yes, Dr. Singhvi.
Please hear this answer. If you have the courage, let Mr. Ravi Shankar not interrupt. Delhi, Haryana,
about 2013,
Rajasthan,
why
Bihar are having growth rates higher than or equal to BJP. Point number one. Point number two,
yes.
The average growth rate from 98 to 2004 of the BJP was less than 5.6%. The average growth rate from 2004 to 2013 today of the Congress and the UPA is higher. But what is more important, till last year, for 9 years out of 10 or 8.5 out of 10, our growth rate has been 1.5 times higher average than that of the BJP. Just because in 1 year our growth rate is less, they are shouting and complaining. The same Prime Minister, the same Council of Ministers, the same Congress Party. Those are hard facts. We reached 9%, 8.6%. Our lowest was higher than your highest.
All right. That was a lot of number throwing from both the BJP and the Congress Party.
Navika, can I say one line?
Whose rule states are actually throwing up?
Navika, can I say one line?
But the one question that we started with, yes, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, I'll allow you that one line and then we'll call this debate to a close. I hope you'll answer the question that we started with.
First of all, the Prime Minister is expressing concern on the economy. The Finance Minister is expressing concern on the economy. The World Bank is expressing concern. The new Reserve Bank Governor is saying, and here is the eloquent spokesperson of Congress Party who is shying away from reality because he has no answer. Coming to the last question, yes, you are right. The country expects an answer. The parliamentary board will take a call, and the people of the country are waiting for the appropriate moment to rid this country of the corruption, scam, tainted governance of Dr. Manmohan Singh, Sonia Gandhi led UPA government.
We've been waiting a long time to know who your prime ministerial candidate will be and when will that announcement actually come, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad. But thank you very much, Dr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi and Ravi Shankar Prasad, for joining us on this debate this evening. Thank you very much.